Good afternoon, Monarchs. I'm Ms. Chavez, your College and Career Readiness Counselor, and I am so happy to be welcoming CNM to the Monarch today to talk to you all about dual credit, admissions, scholarships, touch on some program stuff. It's going to be really cool. We have Ashton So with us today, and he's been with CNM for a couple of years and knows a lot about the programs and opportunities CNM has to offer you. So welcome, Ashton. Thanks for being with us today.
Thanks, Ms. Chavez, for having us here to talk to the students. As you mentioned, my name is Ashton So. I'm a recruitment specialist here at Central New Mexico Community College. I've been with the college for 2 years, so here in Outreach Department, and I'm really glad to be here to talk about what CNM has to offer.
Great. And then you have to share, right?
What was that again?
And are you ready to share that video?
Yeah, we're ready to share.
Okay. All right, we're having a little bit of technical difficulties with the sound, so we're working on that right now because we want you guys to hear it. There's music and words. It almost hits all those senses except for smell. So Ms. Carr is working on that for us in the background. Ashton, when was that video made?
I believe it was
recently, correct?
Yeah, it's a recent video of ours. But it's pretty great. It talks about the different schools, and then it highlights on the more popular programs that are offered. So it's pretty good to watch.
I think we got the issues correct. So try and play it again. There we go.
This is going to be the future, these types of houses. This is an excellent project for students to gain hands-on practical knowledge of what it takes, of what the future is going to be asking of them. The students are able to walk away from here with an understanding of engineering, electrical wiring, this type of plumbing. They're going to be able to take this with them into their career. The possibilities are endless. It is possible to make something and do something good, not only for yourself, but for the community.
Veterinary technicians are in very high demand for the future to work alongside veterinarians in private practice, in laboratory situations, in zoological parks and aquariums, very many different aspects that veterinary technicians could find their employment. We have an excellent employment rate for our graduates, with probably 80% of them being employed within the first 6 months of graduation.
Digital imaging is the way that all of the dental offices are going these days. We've done away with film, so this is more of the green type of dentistry, We've done away with all the chemicals. This is preparing the students for what they'll really encounter in the dental offices. So this lab helps the students prepare for that future that they're getting ready to go into in the new dental labs by teaching them one of the best technologies that we have available to us.
We're preparing students in their last semesters at CNM to be early childhood teachers by sending them out into the field with mentors who have been trained by us, gone through our mentor network program. So they're highly qualified teachers in the field working with our students to give them a really good experience before they graduate. We are raising the bar for teachers in the field and for the centers. And so CNM is doing a very good job of preparing our students for the jobs that they will be encountering for the future.
We're preparing students for a future in the line work industry with some basic theory and a lot of hands-on outdoor classroom work in a semi-real world environment. They're learning how to climb poles, how to work at elevated heights. We're learning basic tools. Right now the need is great all over the nation. There's some good money in the industry. Without linemen, we don't have any electricity. We gotta have somebody that knows how to build it and keep it running for the future.
We prepare the physical therapist assistant students for the future. We give them the latest equipment, the training on how to utilize that equipment from electrical stimulation, ultrasound units, traction tables, to exercise equipment, to anything that they might see in a clinic. So we give them a lot of hands-on experience with state-of-the-art, up-to-date equipment and techniques that are being used out in the clinic. We give them lots of practice prior to launching them out on their careers.
Here at the Deep Dive Digital Media Bootcamp, we're preparing students for their future careers in the digital media industry. The digital media industry is a $120 billion industry in the U.S. and growing exponentially here in New Mexico. Here at the bootcamp, we're preparing students with the fundamental skills they need to be successful in this industry. Things like digital animation production, digital game design and development, and video production using computer-generated imagery, or CGI.
We are flying a drone to document the Clayton Lake dinosaur track site. The dinosaur track site contains hundreds of tracks from 100 million years ago. And right now we are using modern technology to document them to a fraction of an inch, a tiny fraction of an inch. The point is we'll be able to model these in three dimensions, so we'll be able to follow individual dinosaur tracks as they crossed over a muddy area along the ocean shore 100 million years ago.
Wow, that video was so cool. And I know a lot of our students are very interested in working with animals, working in the medical field, working with hands-on stuff in construction and lineman work. So thank you for sharing that. Super awesome.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, that's one of the cool videos that CNM has. You know, it kind of touches on all the programs at the school, kind of gives them a little bit more demonstration and how these programs are carried forward through instruction in class. But yeah, it's a great film. So to get started, again, my name is Ashton So. I'm a recruitment specialist here at Central New Mexico Community College. Again, I've been with the college for 2 years, so I work here in outreach department. So just to tell you a little bit about us, so CNM is actually the largest community college in the state of New Mexico. We serve over 22,000 students here at CNM, so we have a really big enrollment. We actually compete with our neighboring in-state universities, so we serve a lot of students here. We have over 100 associate's degrees and certificate programs. In the film, you got to see some of those programs that we highlighted about. So we do have 9 locations that stretch across Albuquerque and Rio Rancho, and as some of you probably don't know, Sol the Sun Cat is our mascot. If you look below on the slide, you'll see a picture of Sol in the lab and wearing a construction hat. So some of the cool things that we like to pride ourselves is that we have an average class size of 20 students. And the reason being is that having a more smaller class size, it creates a more inclusive learning environment for our students. So we like to keep it that way. That way students get more one-on-one with instructors and things like that. So the average class size among the CNM programs is about 20 students per class. So another great factoid is that upon graduation, 95% of our students, they find employment in their chosen field. So that's a pretty large percentage compared to other universities or institutions. So we like to pride ourselves on that. We like to meet our students where the chosen fields they want to be part of, what they're interested in. So you can kind of see it towards the bottom. We do have 6 academic schools, and we'll go ahead and go through them. So the first school here at CNM is our School of Adult and General Education. The School of Adult and General Education mainly focuses on high school equivalency. So those that are wanting to earn a GED, go through the high set or things like that, they can definitely do so through the School of SAGE. That's just a shorter term for School of Adult and General Ed. So they have developmental courses for those that are wanting to learn more about the subjects and what's provided on the GED exam. Okay, on the next slide here is going to be the School of Applied Technologies. So earlier in the film, you got to see some of the programs in linemen, electrical trades. So a School of Applied Technologies definitely houses those programs, along with automotive, aviation, carpentry, construction. We do have film technology or technician, and then our HVAC programs, truck driving and welding. So again, CNM has over 100 programs, but what's going to be listed on these slides are the more popular ones that students tend to lean towards. So this one's going to be our School of Business and Information Technology. So we have our accounting listed, brewing and beverage management program. We have business programs, computer science. We have a really great culinary arts program, hospitality and tourism, and office and administration. So a lot of these programs, how they're developed and structured is they're geared towards what is called a 2+2 program. Mainly all of our programs are like that. So a lot of students come in, they take their prerequisites with us, their associate's program, and they earn it, their degree and associates. And then they transfer those to a university and work towards their bachelor's degree. Okay, next we have our School of Communication, Humanities, and Social Sciences. So this school is going to house like anthropology, communication, criminology, English, fine arts, modern languages, pre-architecture, theater, and then also our teacher education program. So mainly their teacher education program, we didn't list it on here, but it's actually a growing program for us. It's one of our more sought out programs that the School of Chess offers. Cool, and then this brings us to our School of Health, Wellness, and Public Safety. So the School of Health, Wellness, and Public Safety is one of our larger schools here at CNM. They have programs related to health, programs related to wellness, and then again on public safety, so like cosmetology, criminal justice for public safety, we have dental sciences, diagnostic medical sonography, emergency medical service programs, fire science programs, and one of our more popular ones going to be our nursing program. So CNM is very known for the nursing program. We do have a great partnership with UNM, so that students come and get their associates in nursing, and then they transfer those credits to UNM, and then they earn that bachelor's degree in nursing. So if you want to go through that route, you definitely want a bachelor's degree. So the program through CNM can definitely lead you towards that path. And then lastly, we have our veterinary science. Okay, so moving forward, so we have our School of Math, Science, and Engineering. And just like how the school is named, those are the programs that fall under those subjects. So we have biology, chemistry, planet, Earth and planetary science, engineering, geography, nutrition, physics, and then our pre-health sciences. So we went over the schools that provide, you know, great programs at CNM. And then beginning of the year, back in January, February, CNM launched a brand new CNM online college. So the online college provides only a limited amount of programs. That's just because it's brand new. So we have the associates in liberal arts, business, communications, criminology, business administration. We have a couple certificates here. So we have the digital media marketing certificate, and then also the digital marketing strategy certificate. So the CNM Online College, what it is that you're able to complete a full degree 100% online. So so at the moment, just how everything is going, a lot of our classes are already online, but this one, you can complete the whole program online. Okay, so with the online college, there are two pathways of completing a degree. So we have the guided path. So the guided path is going to be $159 per credit hour. That is different than what the traditional general student would pay. So the guided path, it includes textbooks, materials, access to online tutoring, library resources. You have access to achievement coaches, and then also our disability resource center. So how the guided path is structured is you would take two courses every 7 weeks. So it is an accelerated guided path. So you are encouraged to take at least 6 credits per 7 week term. So the guided path is already a predetermined program path for students. So if you are not wanting to meet with instructors or advisors about what to take next semester, the guided path would already have it predetermined for you, and you would just register for the next class that's on the list. So instructors set the pace and deadline. So that means it's accelerated. You can complete an associate's degree within a 17-month timeframe. Next is going to be our flex path. So the flex path is $700 for unlimited credits. So the tuition is a bit different again, but it does include something similar to the guided path. It includes textbooks, materials, access to online tutoring, library resources, again, achievement coaches, and then the DRC department. So how the flex path is structured is you would take 1 to 2 courses at a time. You are encouraged to complete as many courses as possible in each 7 week period, but it's more self-guided. So you set your own pace and deadlines. Once you completed a course, you can move on to the next. So it's more competency-based. So it goes along the lines of what you're able to complete within that time frame. Okay, so we talked about the CNM Online College, but the tuition rate for a general traditional student is going to be much different. So to be a general student here at CNM, which includes like beginning freshmen, transfer visitor, part-time students, and things like that. So the traditional tuition rate is going to be $56 per credit hour. So as you see on the slide, it kind of breaks it down from 12 to 18 credit hours. You're probably looking around the range of 672 more credit hours. It kind of differs. All right, so paying for college. So CNM accepts public scholarships or are awarded or private scholarships. Some of these also include the Bridge to Success Scholarship. So the Bridge to Success Scholarship is kind of like a preliminary awarding to the New Mexico Lottery. So the Bridge to Success, I believe the deadline is going to be March 31st for next year. So we accept those, we provide those, and then we also have the CNM Foundation Scholarship. So the foundation is like a platform of scholarships that CNM donors contribute to those that are eligible for those scholarships. If you go onto our CNM website and then look up our scholarship page, you'll find hundreds of scholarships that CNM provides through the foundation. And we also encourage our students to apply for FAFSA. It's free. It's a free application for student aid. So it's definitely something that we encourage. So it is a Pell Grant, federal Pell Grant. CNM does offer student loans, but we don't encourage our students to take that route just because our tuition rate is so low that if you were eligible for FAFSA, that would pretty much cover most of your expenses here at CNM. We do provide work study if you're eligible through your financial aid application. So work study is pretty good. You get to work in the various departments here at CNM. You get to gain work experience while you're working towards your degree. So you can work in our admissions department, maybe cashier's department, business, or financial aid department. So you're able to gain experience while you're pursuing your degree here at CNM. And listed below is going to be the contact information for a financial aid and scholarship. So it's www.cnm.edu/financial aid. You can reach them at 505-224-3090 or financialaid@cnm.edu. All right, so as a CNM student, you do have resources made available for you. So we do have the ACE tutoring service. So as a CNM student, you do have access to tutoring. Right now they're doing tutoring online, so remotely. So you can be able to seek help if you're struggling in math, science, English, and other subjects. We do have our assessment center. The assessment center is more or less like our testing center. So if you need to take the AccuPlacer or maybe your instructor schedules an exam through the assessment, that's where you'll be going to take those tests. We have a contact center, and we do have a disability resource center. So the DRC department, they're really great. You know, we have a really great staff there. They're able to help students and parents come in that are needing more assistance. So if you do have like an IEP or something scheduled with your high school, you can actually provide those documents to the DRC, and then CNM will do our best to mimic that program that you had at your high school. So it is a great way to make that smoother transition from high school to college. They do have their own admissions team, advisor team there. So they provide a lot of service for our students. We do have an IT department. So if you're having any tech issues or computer problems, you can actually bring it to our IT department. They can take a look at it, your device, and see if they're able to fix it for you or recommend maybe another place where you can have it fixed for yourself. They also provide students with Office Word, Excel, PowerPoint, and things like that, if you don't have that already installed on your device. And next we have our navigators and academic coaches. So the navigators are actually the ones that help you once you complete your application. So they actually help you through the enrollment process. So they'll help you meet with academic coaches, financial aid. They'll actually help you register for classes. Our academic coaches are the ones that let you know what courses you would take next. So they help you. They help plan out your program, so each semester and things like that. So we do have a security department, and then we have a students' activities and organizations. So the student activities department is a really great department. They help students get involved with CNM. So if you want to charter a club or get involved with student government, you definitely want to reach out to student activities. They help students get connected with these clubs. It looks pretty good on your resume if you're involved with the institution. So I recommend reaching out to them to see what they offer. And then we also have a Veterans Resource Center. All right, so a little bit about dual credit. So dual credit is you're able to take college level courses while you're completing your high school. So the benefits about dual credit is there's a smoother transition from high school to college. You're exposed to college level work while in high school. So if you're taking college classes in high school, by the time you graduate and actually enroll full time here at CNM, you have lesser classes to take to complete that degree. So the thing about dual credit is it's free tuition if your high school has a partnership with CNM. However, there's If you're taking a class that requires like something a little extra, uniforms and things like that, dual credit students would be responsible for course fees and things like that. So public schools, they would actually cover the cost of textbooks for dual credit students. So a little bit more students are able to earn college credits and high school credits for the same class. That's a plus. So you're able to meet the New Mexico high school graduation requirements while working towards a degree at CNM. So again, you have free tutoring. When we were in person, you would have access to our computer lab, but you do have access to the online library now. All right, so the steps to becoming a CNM student, we broke it down into 9 steps. So the first step is you would apply to CNM. We do have an online application. It does take about 15 to 20 minutes to complete. So after you complete the application, our admissions team would process it within 2 to 4 business days. And once that happens, you would get sent an email with your student credentials. It'll contain your student ID number, your CNM email address, and then CNM username. So the next step after that would be to set up your MyCNM account and then apply for financial aid and scholarship. There is a new student orientation that you would need to complete. Right now it is completed online. Afterwards, you can meet with an academic coach to find out what classes you can take for the upcoming semester. And then after meeting with your coach, you would just register for the classes. If you have financial aid, that would pay your tuition. And then you can get your student ID number. Right now the classes are offered online. So probably only special circumstances you would need to come in person. So some of the lab courses that are provided that are not able to be completed online, they're kind of working with students at the moment. They're trying to figure out, how many students at a time to come in to take a lab class and things like that. But for the most part, most of our classes are going to be offered online. And if you do need help applying to CNM, sometimes students have issues with the application, you're welcome to reach out to us. You can contact us at thinkingaboutcnm@cnm.edu, or you can visit our CNM website. So you can go to www.cnm.edu/thinkingaboutcnm, and that would actually connect you to our Ask a Recruiter virtual session. And then you can also reach out to us at 505-224-3352. So that's going to connect you to our main outreach line. But the next slide, it does show my information. So it has my phone number on there, my office line. It has my email address. So you're welcome to contact both. So you can send me an email, or you can call us, and we'll try to answer the questions that you have about enrollment, about programs, or other departments. So,
wow, so much. One of the questions I had was for our current seniors, when will the CNM application be open for them to apply as incoming freshmen for next year?
So the application is currently open. So for spring 2021, summer, and then fall of next year, the applications are all open right now.
Oh, they are.
Mm-hmm. So the admissions team, they went ahead and pushed forward and tried to get applications open just because of how hectic things has been lately. So they're all available.
So usually seniors have to wait till December. So that's good to know.
Mm-hmm.
And when seniors are applying, I know I've encountered some frequently, some problems with clicking an application type that doesn't work. So what advice do you have for our seniors to have a smooth application process?
Yeah, so whether you're currently taking dual credit or you're waiting until after you graduate high school, you would apply as a beginning freshman. So those are a dual credit. Once you apply as beginning freshman, it will just change your student type in the system. And then those that are ready to take classes at their high school, beginning freshman. That would just, that's what you would start off as.
Beginning freshman. Mm-hmm. And usually there's a bridge scholarship. Can you talk a little bit about the bridge?
Yeah, so from what I know about the bridge scholarship, it's kind of like a preliminary to the New Mexico lottery. So the bridge is, the deadline is going to be March 31st for next year. And so I believe the requirements is that you have to be a full-time student, which is 12 credit hours or more. You have to meet the deadline before March 31st, and then you have to have graduated from a New Mexico high school. So those that are here at Manzano, you'll be eligible for the Bridge Scholarship. And once you have a successful scholarship or a successful semester for a fall term, then the spring semester, you'll be awarded the lottery.
Awesome. Perfect. So that's good information for our seniors. For students interested in dual credit, I get a lot of students ask me, at what age can they start taking dual credit classes?
Mm-hmm. So the age, you have to be at least 16 years or older, and you had to be at least a sophomore in high school to take dual credit.
Okay. So what if they're a sophomore and they're not 16 yet?
I believe they kind of stick to the age, yeah. So it might have to wait until they're a junior too.
Okay. And some of our students interested in dual credit, it's different than registering for a high school class. How much time would you say they need to allow themselves to take the ACCUPLACER and complete all those steps before they can register?
Yeah, so I would say at least 2 weeks before the semester starts. But that's kind of like the minimum, like that's kind of like last minute right there. But you definitely want to do it as soon as possible. Once you made up your mind you want to take dual credit, that way you're not rushing around the last minute, because I believe there is a deadline. I don't know what that date is, but they give a deadline to the high school counselors.
Okay. So for those interested in dual credit, starting to plan now would be good for taking a dual credit class next semester.
Absolutely, yeah.
Got it. Well, hopefully we can have you back, maybe just to talk about dual credit and go through the steps. Mm-hmm. But I really appreciate your time today with meeting with us, mm-hmm. and being so open to students contacting you and CNM. So do you have any questions for me before we wrap up?
No questions, but I just want to say thank you again for having me. And my contact was posted earlier. If you have any questions, students have questions, you're more than welcome to reach out. We can do our best to provide information, answers to your questions and things like that. So we're definitely here to help the students with whatever we can do.
Awesome. You're awesome, Ashton. Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.
And Ms. Carr for working her magic backstage. And thank you, Monarchs, for tuning in. And also, let me know if you need any help getting connected to CNM, and I'll do whatever I can to help you get there. Thank you.
Thank you.